lot of different people are interested in feeding their quail, and there are feeders out there on the market that cost you $200. I'll show you how you can make one that works very well for probably less than $10, basically whatever the cost of a metal drum is. You can use any size metal drum. These are 30-gallon drums with the lock ring lids, which is what I prefer. About the only two pieces of equipment that you need are a drill with a 9/32 inch bit. That's for feeding milo. If you were feeding wheat, it'd be 7/32. And then either a steel plunger, in my case today, a Phillips screwdriver. So what we're going to do is drill several holes around the barrel, about an inch off the bottom of the barrel, about right here. Once I have that hole drilled, then I'll take my screwdriver or a steel punch, insert it into the hole, and push downward. And what that does is that creates a little rain hood over that feeding port. So now when the rain hits the barrel, it runs around the hole rather than into the hole. So once we're to that stage, all it consists of now is filling it with milo, putting it up on some kind of a support where that little hole will be about quail's eye height, about 6 inches high. And then if we have cattle in the pasture, we'd stake it in the ground with a T-post or two. Here's a quail feeder that's in position, been working for about 6 months. Very easy to check the level of feed just by pecking on the barrel. This one's about 2/3 full. This particular feeder will hold about 200 pounds of milo. I've got it up on an old wheel rim, which makes a nice solid base. You just want those ports to be about 6 inches higher, about quail's eye height. Now, there aren't any cattle in this pasture. If there were, I'd need to stake one or two T-posts and run me some wire around that to make a good solid support, keep them, as the cattle rubbed on it, it wouldn't knock it over. If you've got feral hogs in your area, what I'd do is sink 4 T-posts, and then I'd run wire across the top up here to keep them from being able to push the thing out and knock it over like that. The beauty of this little feeder is that it's fairly efficient in what it feeds, and Mr. Currie, the way he came up with this novel, with this ideal, was this. He used to have a feeder out in his back porch, out in his backyard. It had a large hole in it here, what I call a mouse hole. The grain just kind of free-flowed through it. And he sat out there sometimes with his .22 to keep the sparrows off the feeder. And one day he shot at a sparrow and he missed. And he shot a .22 caliber size hole in the barrel. He noticed the next quail that came up didn't go to the large hole, but went to a small hole, pecked the milo, and 4 or 5 kernels of milo dropped out. And the light went on in Mr. Currie's mind saying, aha, I can improve the efficiency of my feeder. So he experimented with different sized holes and finally settled on 9/32 inch for milo, 7/32 for wheat. We now call this the Currie Quail Feeder in tribute to Mr. Currie, and we call his miss the miss heard around West Texas, because it's a very novel way to feed quail. Works fairly well. Inexpensive, costs you about $15 to build a feeder. And again, all it takes, and the secret, is that quail walks up, pecks that, half dozen kernels drop out on the ground, the other quail pick it up. It keeps most of the milo off the ground. If the milo's on the ground for any extended period of time, red ants will be your major seed predator. They'll get 90% of your milo. The other big non-target species that you have are raccoons. You'll inevitably have some raccoons working these feeders, and they're basically just a cost of doing business. If you want to control their numbers, what I do is put out some cage traps and trap some of those out if that proves to be a big problem. Anytime you provide feed for deer, quail, or whatever, you should always make sure that it's within the safe limits of aflatoxin or certified as aflatoxin free. Aflatoxin is typically not a problem with milo, but it can be more of a problem with corn. What I'm going to do is just load that milo in here. That feed, how long that feed will last you just depends on how many coveys of quail you have working that feeder, as well as other non-target losses. 200 pounds worth of milo at this particular site will last me somewhere around 3 months during the winter. So it's a situation where you don't have to fill them up very often. I like to put my feeders close to cover. You can see that I've got some good escape cover fairly close to these, so in case there's a bobcat or whatever comes up, those quail have an easy escape route.